Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. In finding the internal rate of return, the initial value is very important and it determines how many steps we have to take before we are able to obtain the internal rate of return by using the interpolation method. By using this calculator trick, we can minimize the steps that we have to take. We just have to press menu. Now, and look for the table function number 9. Enter the functions that we built for the formulas. Negative 4 outflow, positive 4 inflow. So we have negative 10,000 plus 1,000 divided by 1 plus all. We can use x to represent, since as we can see, the function is in terms of x. Plus 4005 divided by bracket 1 plus x square plus 8000 divided by bracket 1 plus x cube. Press equal. Since we don't have the function g, we can press 1 or shift menu for setup. Down, look for table, and we choose function f is enough. So we have only function f, press equal, start from 0%, which is 0, and end at 100%, which is 1. Step we can take 0.1, which means that every time we increase by 10%, and we press equal. And we should look for the value in between positive and negative. So which means that the internal rate of return should in between 0.1 and 0.2. So we press AC, press equal, the start, we should have 0.1 for this time. And end, we should have 0.2 for this time. For the step, we should increase one decimal place, which means that we take 0.01 now and press equal. Again, we check that we have positive and negative in between 0.12 and 0.13. So which means that the internal rate of return is in between these two numbers. So again, press AC, press equal. Start change to 0.12, press equal 0.13 for n. And step, increase one decimal place. So 0.001, press equal, and we should have the value down and down and down. And between 0.127 and 0.128. So instead of taking the initial value 0.1 and 0.2, we can take 0.127 and 0.128. As we can see, if we start with this initial value, we have to take a few steps before we are able to obtain the answer. But if let's say we start with this value, just a few steps, maybe one or two steps, we already obtain the internal rate of return, which is faster. Okay, that's all about this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.